Hello everyone, welcome back to the Chemical Engineering and Aspen channel. As you know, these days we are focusing on the module of Chemical Reaction Engineering. So in this regard, we are bringing the lecture number 16 for our valuable viewers. So in today's lecture, we will solve the example related to the flow system. In the previous lecture on the stoichiometry, we have prepared the stoichiometric table, derived the concentration term for both batch and flow systems. And in flow systems, we have derived a couple of relations, one for the liquid phase system and one for the gas phase system. So today we will solve an example, and the example states that a mixture of 28% SO2 and 72% air is charged to a flow reactor in which SO2 is oxidized. 2 moles of SO2 reacts with 1 mole of oxygen to produce 2 moles of sulfur trioxide. We have to do 3 steps. Number 1. Set up a stoichiometry table using the symbols theta and F. Next, prepare a second table evaluating the species concentration as a function of conversion for the case when the total pressure is 14.7 atm or 1485 kilopascal and the temperature is constant at 227 degrees centigrade. And next, we have to evaluate the parameters and then finally the plot of each of the concentration as a function of conversion. So this is the overall statement of it, and first task we need to do is to specify the limiting reactant, and for this system we will take SO2 as the limiting reactant. And once we have specified the limiting reactant, we have to make its stoichiometry coefficient as 1. So what we need to do, divide the whole equation by 2. So it will be SO2 plus 1 by 2 oxygen goes to SO3. So designating SO2 as A, oxygen as B, and SO3 as C, we can write rate of reaction equation minus RA is equal to KCA C of B, equation that is given in the problem statement. First, we need to build the stoichiometric table. So according to species, SO2, oxygen, SO3, nitrogen, represented as symbol A, B, C, and I respectively. Nitrogen is inert in the system. SO2 and O2 are the reactants in the system, while SO3 is the product in the system. Initially, the flow rate of A species is FA0. For B, it is FB0 or represented as theta B FA0. C is 0. There is no SO3 present initially in the system. And for inert, it is FI0 is equal to theta I FA0. And once we sum all of these, it will be FD0. For the change, we will say for the limiting reactant, it is minus FA0X. Then minus B over A, so accordingly B over A is 1 over 2, so 1 over 2 FA0X. Then C over A FA0X, so C over A is 1 over here, so accordingly FA0X, and there is no change in inert. Then remaining will be FA is equal to FA0 minus FA0X, or accordingly it will be FA0 into 1 minus X. Then adding these two to calculate F of B, which is theta B FA0 minus FA0X over 2, taking FA0 common from it, it will be FA0 theta B minus 1 over 2 into X. For this, 0 plus FA0X, so F of C is equal to FA0X, and for F of I is equal to FI0, and that is equal to theta I FA0. So once we sum all of these, it will become FT0 minus FA0X over 2. Once you add up all of these, it will be converted like this. So this is how the stoichiometric table is built, and we have already prepared it for the batch system, for the flow system, and we have discussed over there in detail. Now expressing the concentration as a function of conversion, which is our second task, we know that C of A is equal to FA over small v, where F is the molar flow rate and V is the volumetric flow rate. And F of A, which is at the outlet, is equal to FA0 into 1 minus X over V. Then we know V is equal to V0, 1 plus epsilon X, P0 over P, T over T0. We have derived that in our previous lecture for the gas phase system, and since it's a gas phase flow system, so we have to use that one. If that would have been a liquid system, it would simply have been V is equal to V0. Since it is given the statement that there is no pressure drop and the temperature is constant, so accordingly T over T0 will be cancelled out and P0 over P will be cancelled out. So we will be left with V is equal to V0, 1 plus epsilon X. And now substituting that value over here, so once it will become CA is equal to FA over V, FA goes to FA0 1 minus X, while V goes to V0 1 plus epsilon X. So that FA0 over V0 will goes to CA0, CA0 1 minus X over 1 plus epsilon X. Similarly, for C of B is equal to F of B over small v, V goes to V naught, F of B goes to F A naught theta B minus B over A into X, so that will become as C A naught theta B minus 1 by 2 X over 1 plus epsilon X, and same would be the C of C, same would be the C of I. For the third part, which is the parametric evaluation, C A naught is equal to Y A naught into C T naught. We have derived that expression in our previous relationship as well, or we can simply say that this is the mole fraction. So mole fraction is equal to concentration of that species divided by the total concentration. So that is how it is adjusted. And that C T naught, if you remember ideal gas law, that is equal to P naught over R T naught. Because it is naught, so that's why naught symbols are placed over here and R is constant in the system. Now that C A naught is equal to 0.28, which is Y naught in the system, because we have been given that the feed contains 28% SO2. So the mole fraction in the feed is 28% or 0.28. P naught is given as 1485 kilopascal. The value of R is 8.314 kilopascal cubic decimeter over mole Kelvin, and T naught is 500 Kelvin. So we get 0.1 mole per cubic decimeter of initial concentration of the limiting reactant. For C of T, if we see here, that is equal to Ft over V. Ft is equal to Ft naught plus Y naught sigma x Ft naught. We have derived that expression in our previous slides as well. V naught 1 plus epsilon x. This factor Y naught sigma goes to epsilon. So Ft naught is taken out from here common. You can see Ft naught plus the sigma and Y naught goes to epsilon x Ft naught. So Ft naught is taken common out from here. But it will become Ft naught 1 plus epsilon x. At the denominator is V naught 1 plus epsilon x. So these two terms will cancel out. This will be Ft naught over V naught, and that is equal to Ct naught, which means that the initial concentrations are equal to the final concentration. It means that the total concentration will remain the same throughout the system. And Ct naught is equal to P naught over Rt naught. So that is 0.357 mole per cubic decimeter. We will see why that calculations were needed for the system. And finally, that epsilon, that is equal to Y naught sigma. Y naught is 0.28. And if you remember, that sigma is D over A, C over A. These two were added, minus B over A and minus 1. So C over A is 1, B over A is 1 by 2, and remaining one is minus 1. So these two will be cancelled out. So it will be minus 0.14. So accordingly, you see CA is equal to CA naught, 1 minus X over 1 plus epsilon X. We have derived it previously, so Ca naught is 0.1 and 1 minus x over 1 plus, so this epsilon is minus 0.14, so accordingly 1 minus 0.14 into x. Similarly, Cb is equal to Ca naught theta b minus 0.5 x over 1 plus epsilon x. Now if you remember, theta b was Fb naught over Fa naught, so that is 0.54. How for this, look here, that Fa naught is equal to Ya naught into Ft naught, and Ya naught is 0.28 in the system. For Fb naught, it is 0.72 into 0.21 because it is 72% air. However, in air, only oxygen will react. So 72% of 21%, which is the oxygen in the system, into Ft naught, that will be included. So once you divide these two terms over here, and that will become theta b. So theta b is equal to Fb naught over Fa naught. This Ft naught will be cancelled out with this Ft naught, 0.72, 72% of oxygen divided by SO2, so accordingly it will be 0.54. So that is why theta b is mentioned over here as 0.54 minus 0.5x over 1 minus 0.14 into x. Similarly, C of C is equal to Ca naught x over 1 plus epsilon x, so it is simply 0.1. And for this Ci, that is Ca naught theta I over 1 plus epsilon x, so Ca naught is 0.1, theta I is 2.03. How? Look here, that theta I is equal to Fi naught over Fa naught. Way how Fb naught is calculated, in the same way Fi naught will be calculated, that it is 72% of 0.79, which is nitrogen, over 0.28, so it will be 2.03. So accordingly, 0.1 into 2.03 over 1 minus 0.14 into x. Now we got these four terms, Ca, Cb, C of C and C of I. So accordingly, we will draw a plot from here, but we will do that in our next lecture, because we have to solve it comprehensively on the Excel sheet as well. So that's it from today's lecture. Thank you so much. Please do watch, like, share the video and subscribe to the channel. Also click on the bell icon to get all updates related to this channel. Till then, it's goodbye. Stay tuned for more exciting videos on this channel.